Hi, this is Sky Perry with SSP Innovations, and I'm here to talk to you about a new piece of Esri functionality that was just released recently in April 2016, and that is the Esri gas valve isolation tracing. Now, this is exciting for us because this is the first time we've seen a utility-specific trace released within the core tools, and it's been released as part of the new Esri utility and pipeline data model, so UPDM. So as you see on the left here, I've loaded a UPDM data source here, and the entire purpose of this is to basically be able to click on the map and isolate an area by finding the valves that would have to be operated to isolate gas flowing to a given area. So with that, let's jump right into the trace functionality. To start off, I will go ahead and add a flag, and we can place this flag if we need to isolate anywhere in this area, and it'll snap to the gas pipe there. The next piece is really just to run the trace at the most basic level, and we'll run the connected isolation trace tool. And I will again click near that flag. This will trace out and find the area. So notice that it's selected all of the records that will essentially be included in the outage if we operate the given valve. And you know, one of my favorite things is over here on the left is that the trace results are added as a group layer to this window. So I can actually take that and reorder this and place it below my records there. So let's go and zoom into these areas here and take a look at what we're finding here. So it found that it basically was going to operate valve 227 here, which would isolate this whole given area. And you can see the full extent of that area highlighted there in green, as well as by the selected records. Now I can inspect these selected records by clicking the Identify Selected Records button. And that would let me pull up and page through all of the individual meter sets, as well as get down there to that specific gas valve that needs to be operated. So if I move that over here, we should be able to see that flashing on the screen, and that would work just fine. So the next key piece of a valve isolation trace would be able to mark a given valve as not being operable. So mark it as inoperable, it could be paved over, any other issue, maybe it's not even a critical valve. We can filter, by the way, on only critical valves within the configuration for the tool, but for right now, we just want to mark this specific valve here, and I'll zoom back into it, as inoperable. So I'll go ahead and clear my selection. And what I'm going to do now is actually utilize a tool here on the toolbar, which is change the operable status of a valve. Now, as I go ahead and go in here and click on this valve, notice it's now flipping it accessible, the field accessible, over to false, indicating that that valve is no longer accessible. So we're using fields behind the scene to drive that functionality. But with that change, I can now go, and I don't have to rerun the full trace, I can rerun the trace just as I ran it before. So it'll go ahead and use the same components of the trace that I ran the first time and find new results. And you can see here now it's a much larger area on the map. Now, one of the neat things, again, is it's been added as a separate trace result to the map, and we know this is a larger area. So if I simply drag this down below trace results number one, and I'll go ahead and clear my selection for the moment, you can see the full extent of the trace in red. We can see the results of my first trace here in green, and then now in this orangish color, a much larger area. And it's indicating that we have valves up on this northern side that would need to be operated. We could zoom in and see, yes, there are two valves there that would isolate this given area. So very quickly able to see those two results. And the final piece that I wanted to show you guys is that there is the ability to place a squeeze off. So again, if we have plastic pipe, we can place a squeeze in the field, which acts as a temporary barrier to that trace. So that would be sort of the third potential thing I would want to show within this trace. This is a well-known trace we've used in utilities for years. So we'll go and do that. We're going to use this tool of adding a barrier. So this will act as a squeeze. Let's just say we can tap off this pipe here. You see the diamond feature placed there on the map. So I'll place that, and then one more time we'll come and rerun the connected isolation trace, again using the same start points that we used in our first traces. And we see yet a third set of trace results shown on the map here. So as I drop those in between the two there, and in fact, we might even go in and change the coloration there on number three to be a slightly distinct color. Let's just say rose. You can see that a little bit more clearly. So you can see now on the map, I'll zoom out. The very first area, which was the green area, very small. We then, of course, marked that valve as inoperable, and it found two additional valves up here on the northern side. But then we placed a squeeze on this pipe here, and you can see that it got an intermediate point with those trace results here shown in the pink color. And I can rearrange these any way I want to if I want to bring up trace results number three on top. So if that's our final list there, we're able to move forward with that trace. works very easily, and it's using a combination of the Esri attribute assistant behind the scenes for the as-built analysis or as-built editing side. And then we're utilizing a core out-of-the-box trace from Esri available to be plugged in via a simple Esri add-in, which is as simple as double-clicking on an add-in file that you download from Esri and making the trace available to a user on a desktop. So with that, that's my quick demonstration. I hope you found it as quick and as easy as I did to check it out. Thanks for listening.